Landing on the moon is difficult to do successfully, with many missions failing despite substantial investment. Recent examples include Intuitive Machines' lunar landers, which tipped over in 2023 and 2024, and Japanese missions in 22, 23 and 24, which faced software issues or power generation failures. A Russian lander crashed in 2023, and a US mission by Astrobotic burned up in Earth's atmosphere after failing to reach lunar orbit. Startups often struggle more than national space agencies. Over the last 5 years, only 5 of 11 lunar landing attempts succeeded, a 45% success rate. Soft landings like Japan's SLIM and Intuitive Machines lander count as successes even with limited operations. Given the difficulty of powered descents, Lunar Cargo proposes unconventional methods to deliver payloads to the moon's surface. These concepts, though currently theoretical, can get people thinking creatively about entirely new ways delivering cargo to the moon. I'll finish off with another idea that could have some potential at a later date, after a lunar outpost has been established and the lunar economy is ramping up. Okay, let's explain the first concept from Lunar Cargo. Momentum absorption capture for express deliveries on non-atmospheric somata, or Mesodonus. Lunar Cargo, founded in Greece in 2021, developed Mesodonus to deliver payloads to the moon's surface without propulsive landings. A horizontal net positioned at a high altitude site, like a mountain or crater rim, captures payloads, slowing their horizontal velocity similar to arrestor wires on aircraft carriers. A mothership in low lunar orbit deploys payloads to the net every 2 hours. The net, made of smart material with spring-like tension, absorbs the payload's momentum over a 10-kilometer deceleration zone. A trampoline-like structure then catches the payload. Rovers retrieve and organize the cargo at the delivery site. After each delivery, an electric current resets the net's springs, preparing for the next payload. Mesodonus eliminates ejecta, a major issue in lunar landings, where low gravity and no atmosphere allows debris to reach orbital speeds, risking damage to infrastructure and orbiting satellites. The net, crafted from durable anti-ballistic textile, withstands impacts without shattering. The system's scalability allows it to capture payloads ranging from small packages to fully loaded landers, offering a non-propulsive alternative that reduces landing complexity. Lunar Cargo has patented the technology and is seeking funding to advance development. The system won the Moon Village Association's Moon Market Award in 2024. Lunar Cargo has proposed another non-propulsive landing system, even more unconventional. For completeness, we'll cover that concept next. Oversized payload lander on non-atmospheric somata, UPLONAS. Lunar Cargo's UPLONAS delivers large payloads to the moon's surface without propulsion. A giant wheel with a cylindrical hub housing the payload forms the core of the system. The hub can later function as a habitat. High tensile xylon tethers link the hub to a gum metal rim, and both materials can be reused for lunar infrastructure post-landing. The wheel spins at 8.6 revolutions per second before landing, creating centrifugal forces that tighten the rim. This protects the hub from terrain hazards like rocks and aligns the rim's speed with the ground to eliminate displacement friction. Rolling friction slows the wheel to a stop. Ejecta produced have low momentum, staying below lunar escape velocity and confined to a narrow swath, minimizing risk to infrastructure. UPLONAS avoids the high ejecta velocities of traditional landers, which reach 4 km per second and exceed the moon's 2.3 km per second escape velocity, creating widespread hazards. UPLONAS ejecta peak at 1.6 km per second, remaining localized. The system navigates obstacles up to 27 meters tall and requires no fuel, using rolling friction to stop. This reduced costs, enabling delivery of oversized payloads and improving competition to lower lunar cargo expenses. Lunar Cargo is developing UPLONAS as a cost-effective, non-propulsive landing solution with potential to transform lunar logistics. Before we finish this video, since we're discussing non-propulsive methods of delivering cargo to the moon, one other method comes to mind. Space elevator. A lunar space elevator consists of a cable anchored to the moon's surface, extending into space with a counterweight to maintain tension. This system enables rocket-free transport of materials from the Moon to space, supporting lunar mining, settlement, and exploration. The Moon's low gravity, 1/6 of Earth's, reduces the strength required for the cable compared to an Earth-based elevator. The absence of an atmosphere eliminates weather-related challenges like lightning, corrosion, wind, or air resistance, simplifying design and engineering. Challenges. Developing a cable material strong enough for the elevator remains a key hurdle, even in reduced gravity. Manufacturing a continuous defect-free ribbon thousands of kilometers long is essential, as flaws could lead to failure. Anchoring the cable requires a robust base, as the Moon's loose regolith is unsuitable, requiring deep excavation. Solar radiation may degrade the cable's strength over time. The project's high costs and need for advanced lunar engineering and manufacturing capabilities add further complexity. A lunar space elevator consists of a cable anchored to the Moon's surface, extending 60,000 kilometers to the Earth-Moon L1 Lagrange point, with a counterweight to maintain tension. Let's dive into the tensile strength needed for a space elevator cable, as this is the key challenge. Tensile strength requirements. The cable requires a tensile strength of 5 to 10 gigapascals to support its weight and payloads in the Moon's low gravity. The Earth-Moon's system's tidal forces reduce stress compared to an Earth space elevator, which would require material with a tensile strength of between 50 and 100 gigapascals. Maximum stress occurs at L1 or the anchor, depending on the design of the system. Materials like xylon and M5 fiber are viable with tapered designs or counterweights. Manufacturing a 60,000 km defect-free cable is a huge engineering challenge. However, existing materials like xylon could work, especially with optimized designs like tapering or a large counterweight beyond L1. Unlike the Earth, a space elevator for the Moon is feasible with current technology and would completely transform lunar logistics and enable further space exploration out into the solar system. Final thoughts on lunar cargo delivery. Innovative solutions for lunar cargo delivery, while not yet practical, are worth considering because of the high delivery costs to the Moon's surface using propulsive methods. Delivering 1 ton of equipment to the Moon's surface costs $1 billion today. And even with advancements like Starship, costs may only drop to hundreds of millions. A commercially viable lunar economy will require massive reductions in transportation costs. What creative strategies could make lunar payload delivery more affordable? Share your ideas in the comments. Thanks for watching. Space News Live is on Saturday evening or Sunday morning, depending where you watch from. I recap the videos I posted this week, answer questions, respond to comments and chat messages, cover any missed news, and preview upcoming content. I'd love for you to join if you can. Be sure to like and subscribe so you see our upcoming videos. We make videos every week covering the space industry, with an emphasis on the smaller space startups that aren't covered so well on other channels. See you soon.